My name is Eunah Lee, and we are at the NIH Clinical Center. We all know our blood type. So we could be A positive, for example. There are 35 blood group systems, and not many people know that. One of the blood group systems is called Sienna. As an intern, my goal is to sequence, find the genetic code of the full-length protein that encodes the Sienna blood group system. I've always been interested in science, that's a given. My dad used to be a scientist and he used to be interested in microbiology. Interestingly, when I got into college and I started looking at the science courses, microbiology really hit me as a very interesting topic. So my first genetics class hooked me and made me look for genetics laboratories to see if I could get a sense of what the wet lab was like in genetics. When I was studying genetics, what interested me most were like the ethical issues that arise from modern genetic technology. So now my main interest is in genetics and ethics. We have information that we're uncovering now. As an intern, I'm going to be submitting some pieces of code, genetic code, into databases that all these scientists use all over the world. So that's super exciting. I'm going to continue sequencing all the individuals that we have samples from. So we have genotypic information from major sequencing technologies, but the genotype is both of your parents' chromosomes mixed in you. And what we want to do is to uncover the sequence on one strand. So like that one strand from your mom or that one strand from your dad and see what makes you up. So we have computers doing that. We have software programs. And the interesting thing is that the software programs that I'm using are giving slightly different results. So that's another thing that I'm looking out for. There is a wet lab technique to bypass that and actually uncover the haplotype information on one chromosome. But that just takes a long time to do. So I carry this handy dandy notebook around with me the whole day, and I record as I do PCR. The goal is to amplify little pieces of the gene, and amplify meaning just make lots and lots of copies of it. And so after I do that, I check to see if they're amplified using a technique called gel electrophoresis. And if they did make lots of copies of that DNA sequence, then the gel will show bands, and I will know that I was successful. And after that, I purify what I get, and I prepare it for the sequencing machine. And once I load the wells into the sequencer will use capillary gels and figure out the individual base pairs on the whole sequence. Through this summer, I got to experience the power of modern genetic technology firsthand. And right now, genetics is such a hot field, and there's so many exciting avenues to explore. So I've also learned in lab that there's lots of instances where things don't go out the way they should or the way that you want them to, and there's limits to the technologies even now. One thing I would recommend to any student interested in lab is to search for really good mentors, because they make or break the experience.
Hi, Dr. Gleidel.
Hello, how are you doing?
Good.
How's it going today?
It's going pretty well.
In my case, my mentors were very experienced, so they were able to give me reasonable goals for the summer. And whenever you have a problem, they know what to do immediately. And from that, it can really catalyze your learning experience in the lab, and you will learn very, very quickly.